Ahoy, this is Zdenka. You guys asked, and I listened. Many of you got brand new camera, maybe Canon EOS M50 or some other camera, and you are trying to get organized, you are trying to figure out your video settings. And that is the question I get asked the most these days. What are your video settings? Quick and easy tutorial today, let's go. And for the new faces, welcome! My name is Zdenka Darula. I work as a photographer since 2007. If you enjoy tech reviews, tutorials, and fun creative camera challenges, you might want to hit the subscribe button. Intro is finished. Let's dive in into video settings. There are three sets of numbers which never change. They always stay the same no matter what. If I'm shooting myself talking like right now, or if I'm shooting a b-roll of landscape or city, where it is in a real speed, my settings are 24 frames a second, and shutter speed has to double, it is 1/50th. For B-roll, if I want to slow it down a little bit and shoot at 60 frames per second, shutter speed would be on Canon EOS M50, 1/125th of a second. If I want to shoot at super slow motion at 120 frames per second, shutter speed would be 1/250th of a second. Next two numbers will change depending on what I'm filming, and that is aperture and ISO. Let's look at the aperture. If I am filming myself indoors, like right now, I have it set at the lowest aperture possible. I have 15 to 45 millimeters kit lens. The lowest aperture I can get there is 3.5. That's what I'm gonna be using. So 3.5 aperture because I want myself sharp and I want shallow depth of field. I wanna make sure everything else is blurry. And for this setup indoors, I don't need an ND filter. The same thing applies if I'm shooting outdoors. Myself, again, I keep aperture at 3.5, making sure I'm sharp, the background is blurry, but I have to use ND filter to block the excessive light. If I'm filming B-roll sequence of object, close-up object, then again, I keep the aperture on the lowest number possible, depending on the lens I am using, to make sure that the object is nicely sharp and everything else is kind of blurry. I get that cinematic look. The only time I bring the aperture up is if I want a more sharpness in the scene, if I'm filming something big, such as big landscape, big city, and I want everything nice and sharp, I don't need such a shallow depth of field, then I bring it to 5.6, maybe 7, but I usually don't like to go too high, it's just my personal preference. The last number which changes all the time is ISO. If I'm shooting on a bright sunny day outdoors, ISO is set to 100. The darker it gets, ND filter comes off, and then obviously I try to keep the ISO as lowest as possible, so 100, maybe 200, depending how much light is outdoors. If I'm shooting indoors, I'm not using any ND filter. I have this light set up on me, which is pretty strong. Right now the ISO is 200. If I don't have this light and I'm shooting indoors, I try to keep the ISO as lowest as possible. Usually, I try to make sure I get some kind of a light source so I don't have to go up with the ISO. The color profile on this camera, Canon EOS M50, is set to standard. White balance, if I'm shooting indoors with this light, I have it set to sunny. If I'm shooting outdoors when it's sunny, obviously I have it on sunny. If it's overcast, I put it to overcast. Digital image stabilization is set to off, and that's all. That's all I have set for my camera. Those are all my settings. Hit the thumbs up button if you liked today's video, if you found it useful. Subscribe to all future videos. Let me know in the comment section below if there are any other settings you want me to go through on Canon EOS M50, what you would like to learn about Canon EOS M50 in general, or if you want to say hello, say hello. I always read it all and I always respond. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next one. Ciao. Ahoy.